If you put someone's name in the subject line of your email, that's going to help you with the open rates, right? Right. But what happens if someone hasn't yet provided you with their name and they're on your mailing list? Does your email still look okay? Maybe not. In today's video, I'm going to show you some really cool tips and tricks that can help make sure that your subject line still looks really good, whether you know what someone's first name is or not. So let's get into it. Hello, and my name's Rod. Welcome to the channel if it's your first time here. In today's video, I'm going to talk to you about tips and tricks to make sure that if you are wanting to use someone's name in an email, such as in the subject line or even in the body text, that you're using code that will also have a good fallback if someone's name isn't known. I'm going to be specifically taking you through how this works in Klaviyo because it happens to be my favorite email management system. So let's jump on the computer. So first, I'll just show you an example from one of my very favorite brands, which is Mask, how sometimes things don't work out if you don't do it correctly. So this one here is a good example. Because we've done work with Mask before, then I've got several different email addresses in their system. One of my email addresses doesn't have my first name associated with it. So you can see how the subject line just looks a little bit odd. It's just got a comma and then the rest of the subject line, and this one does. So why does that happen? Well, this is why. In the Klaviyo documentation, and even when you're creating your emails from scratch, they'll use a template tag code that's like this. So if we use this example from Mask, the code they use in their email probably looks something like this. So it's the first name, and then the default, if the first name isn't known, the default is just empty text, no space, then the comma, and then the rest of the subject line. So how can you make it so that that is a lot better? Well, this is how you do it. So this is the old way, and the new way is to use a if else statement so that we can craft the subject line how we would like it to be, whether there is a name that's known or not. So in this example, we're saying, okay, if the person's first name is known, let's put their first name in. Now we're also using the pipe symbol, then title. What that means is if somebody's name is in your Klaviyo system, just in lowercase, there's no capital letter at the beginning of the name, which is pretty common. I see that a lot. Then it will actually title case their name, and then there'll be a comma. And if not, then we're going to just skip their name and we're going to say, hey, there. So the result will look a bit like this. So if my name is known, then that's going to be the subject line. But if it's not known, then that's going to be the subject line. So it's still capitalized at the beginning. Here's another example. This code here, once this renders, if the person's first name is known, then it's going to be like that. And if it's not known, then the name just gets skipped. And you see how the word R is then capitalized and we get a nice looking subject line. Now the template language or the tag language that's used in Klaviyo is called Django. It's spelled D-J-A-N-G-O. So if you look up the Django documentation, you can get loads of ideas about how you can use those tags in different ways to render different text in your Klaviyo emails. That's it for today's video. Pretty short and sweet. Hopefully you now understand how you can craft your subject lines anytime you want to include someone's name in an email, whether you have it or not, so that things still read nicely and look professional. If you found today's video useful, then please go ahead and hit the like button. Click subscribe if you like. If you've got any comments or questions about today's content, please drop them in the comment box below, and I'll catch you in the next video.